Lester, what am I holding in my hands?
Eggs. Okay, challenge is over. Nap time.
Just a moment, my flea-bitten friend. I challenge you to make these eggs follow your written instructions.
Phew, eggs are not the only thing that's cracked around here.
Take this marker, please, and write the letter S on this egg for sink, all right? And write the letter F for float on the other egg.
I gotta humor him. He signs my checks.
Now, I didn't change them in any way, shape, or form.
Okay. I've done my part. Astound me.
All right. I take the egg, marked S for sink, and I drop it into a beaker of water, and voila.
It sinks.
Now, I take the other egg, marked F for float, and I drop it into the other beaker of water, and
it floats. I don't know, Beekman. I'm not going to ask you what's the trick, because you've drilled it into my head 1,000 times. In science, there are no tricks.
Well, actually, this one is a trick. But there's also science to back it up. Here's the trick part. This beaker of water is just a beaker of water. But I've put sugar into this beaker of water.
Why should that make a difference?
Well, you see, this is where the science comes in. For things to float, they have to be less dense than the stuff they're floating in. Now, eggs are denser than water, but they're less dense than water with enough stuff dissolved in it, like sugar.
Do you mean that the sugar in this water is keeping this egg from sinking?
Exactly.
No, I'm not buying it. You see, he's gotta be using trick eggs. This one that's been floating is hollow.
No, Lester, it's just a regular egg.
It's hollow.
No, it is not.
It is too.
Is not.
It is too.
Excuse me, I gotta go.